Tony Doherty here for NPC News Online, ready to interview Dexter the Blade Jackson when Phil Heath pops up. So this is going to be a double interview. And what's going to happen now, we're going to say for the first time, welcome five-time Arnold Classic champion winner. How good does that feel, Dex?
Man, that feels incredible, man. It's just a dream come true to be able to flex, to break the, you know, the record that Flex and I, you know, had. So it's just amazing, man.
Amazing. Now, did you think you had it in the bag after the pre-judging? Because I think most of the bodybuilding people around here did. I did. What do you think, Phil?
Well, I wasn't at the pre-judging, but the word around the word around the expo was that it was Dexter's show. A lot of guys look great, but I was actually asking a lot of fans, who you guys have, and a lot of them said Dexter Jackson.
Yeah, I was checking out online, seeing what everyone said. We're pretty confident. Now, what about you?
I never go by that because, everybody got their fans, and even though they know some dude's not going to be nowhere near the top, they got him winning. So everybody got their own fans, you know what I'm saying? So I never paid attention to that. I listen to more guys like you, and I talked to Phil, the other day or whatever, and some of the top officials who know bodybuilding, and that's what they write about. So when I hear them say something good, then it's all good.
Starts feeling good. Right. Now, everybody bought their A-game. A lot of people were thinking this was going to be a weaker lineup because Phil wasn't doing it, and Kai wasn't doing it, and Wolf wasn't doing it, but it turned out to be a cracking show, and absolutely, everyone bought their A game, and there was a lot of depth in the lineup. Did you feel that?
Yeah, very competitive. I knew I can win if I came in at my best. You know what I'm saying? With just a tad bit, a little bit of improvements. And I knew if I didn't, and I slipped a little bit, that I would get beat by a few of these guys. So that was the main thing, was to make sure that I stayed focused. You know what I'm saying, and brought my best package.
We're just talking about old wine. Phil just says it keeps just getting better. Now, you got a guy like Branch who's always at your heels, and you two go at it. But this kid Compton comes on. He's 21 years younger than you. 20 years younger than you. Yeah. That's unbelievable. And you're beating guys 20 years younger. How the hell are you doing that?
I don't know.
I got to find that out as well. I mean, I just definitely want to tell Dexter. I mean, you basically solidified yourself as an all-time greatest, champion in bodybuilding, because not only did you win 5 Arnold Classic championships, I mean, you beat a lot of guys while doing that. I mean, you beat me doing it. You beat, a lot of impressive bodybuilders. And even when people had counted you out numerous times, even in this show, you steadfast, you train hard, you're being focused. You didn't pay attention to what other people say. And like I told him on the phone once, I said, it's interesting because guys like him and Branch, they have something that some other guys just don't have, which is, a different type of grit, a different type of sense of urgency. And we got to see that, tonight with those two guys going after it with these quite younger guys. I mean, I hate to say it, but I mean, Dexter, I told him, I said, you win this show, you basically get to say, I beat all you young cats. Yeah. And he really did. I mean, it's encouraging even for guys like myself I'm 35 years old and realize, gosh, this guy is winning the Arnold Classic. 10 years older than I am, I don't even think I'll be competing that long, let alone be able to, honestly, being able to compete at that level takes...
And to stay motivated and keep coming in shape.
The genetics are ridiculous. The hard work is ridiculous. When talent means hard work, I mean, gosh, look at him. I mean, and that's what makes a champion.
But it's consistency for so long, Phil.
For sure.
We're about to do our 15th chapter of the Arnold Classic, the Australian pro turning into the Arnold Classic. Guess who was in the first one?
Of course.
He's never been out of shape since.
Well, that's the cool thing about it, is that he gets to go on an amazing ride and ride this out, through Australia, get to meet a lot of fans, and remind them that it doesn't matter how old you are, it matters how good you are.
Yeah, absolutely. And he's been through 3 generations of our sport. You've watched guys coming up on their way out, start and finish while you're still competing, and watch them all retire. And now you've beaten the young guys. It's just incredible.
It really is, also because this is a gentleman that a lot of people fail to realize, especially the younger generation. They forget that this man has won at pretty much every level, from amateur through pro.
Yeah.
Every level. Like in boxing, you could say that the guys won at, every weight class. Yeah. And those guys would be considered some of the greatest of all time. Yeah. So it's Dexter's night. He looked incredible. I'm definitely going to be sending him a lot of, baked goods going after these shows. And, but all seriousness, Dexter, you look incredible, man. I'm very proud of you. You did an amazing job. And, you know, you beat a great champion in Branch Warren as well.
I mean, he just keeps coming back.
And he keeps coming back.
I love Branch to death, man. That's my boy, man. Out of all the people in this sport, you know, Branch is one of my good friends, I consider. You know what I'm saying? One of my good friends.
You just can't write him off.
No, you can't write him off either.
A message for the fans.
Oh, I just want to thank everybody, man, for all the love and support that you show me and my family. I'd like to thank my girlfriend, Gail, for all that she does for me. And also, I'd like to thank the Lord Jesus Christ, man, for getting me here and letting me compete and stay in the game so long. Because without them and my parents' genetics, I wouldn't be here. Thank you.
We're out.
I'm sad. This guy's amazing.
We'll see you guys. Yeah. Next time we interview, it'll be at the Olympia. And you'll be up there again. And I'll see you next week.
We're done. Yes, sir.